Welcome back to Gideros and our 3D project. Okay, so we prepared our assets, 3D assets, so that's my ship. And I've got some more prepared, so that's my project, assets, 3D models, that's my player one, and I've got some enemies. Oh, why isn't it textured? Well, the texture is missing, but I had some texture and some missiles. Oh, the texture seem to be missing. Okay, so that doesn't matter, because today we focus on the player, so we want to add the player into the game. Let's do this. So that's my project. When I run it, I've got this, and I see a little mistake here. Instead of 3, that should be 0. So that's in my lives and score. I need to change this value to this one. This variable to this one. Score. When I hit run, okay, cool. Score is 0. And another little thing I don't need is to create a local variable for the require. So I just delete this and it should work the same. Okay, so let's do this. So now, when I refresh my folder, I've got all my assets here. So the player one is in this folder, player one OBG. Okay, now we need to create the code for the player OBG for the ship 01. So I can create a class. So I'm going to create a class for the player, and I'm creating the class in the player one folder. So add new file, and I'm calling the class player one. So that's the file name, and I'm going into the file and I create my class. So the class name is player one equals core dot class. That's a simple class. And then we can init the class. Function player one colon init and op and. Okay, that's it. So now we need to add some parameters to the init function. I'm going to create a parameter for the world, for the 3D world. So x world. That's the first parameter. Second parameter is the path to the object, to the ship 01 OBG. So the path is going to be called X OBG path. And the OBG name is going to be X OBG name. That's it, that's all I need. OBG name will be ship 01.OBG. Now I can load the OBG file. File. So the object, the OBG self. I'm creating a class variable because I will need to access it in another function into the class. In the class, self.obg equals load obg, and we need to pass the path x obg path and the name to the obg x obg name. Okay, next I need to create the body, the obg body. Self dot obg dot body equals Let's go to the wiki. Plugins. React Physics 3D. So first step is create the 3D world. So that's done. Create your body. Okay, so that's what you need. R3D world, create body. Create body. R3D world, so we need to call our world and column create body matrix. So the world is X world. Create body. Hop, create body. And we need to pass. That's not the B2, that's R3D create body transform. Transform, so that's a matrix, and the matrix is the position and rotation of the object. So I can call self.obj get matrix. And that's it for the body. Now I need to create. Let's go back. React Physics. Define the shape of your body. Okay, now I need to create the shape of my body. The body shape. So what's the shape? It's the shape of the object. So when React Physics 3D calculates collisions, it's going to take the shape into account. So for this object, the ship, I'm going to create a sphere shape. So let's do this. Define the shape of your body. A sphere. So what do I need? Create a new collision sphere shape. Fixture. R3D sphere shape. Okay. Going to create a local. Local. I can make. Okay, let's create a local. Or self.obj.shape equals R3D. And then it's R3D sphere shape dot new. R3D dot sphere shape dot new. And we need to pass the radius of the shape. So the radius is, we can make a guess like 8, for example, for the radius, or we can calculate the size of the object. So let's do this. Local, let's create some variables. Local variables. Min x, min y, and min z equals self.obj.min, and then we pass number 1, that's for the x axis. Self.obj.min 2, that's for the y axis, and self.obj.min number 3, that's for the x axis, no, the z axis. So that's the minimum point in the shape. So the location of the minimum point in the shape. So that's the lowest point in the OBG shape. And we have the same for the maximum. So local, max x, max y, and max z equals self.obj.max. And we pass the first, that's the x axis, self.obj.max 2 for the y axis, self.obj.max, and 3, that's for the z-axis. So that's the maximum point in the shape. So that's the location of the maximum point in the shape. So we've got the minimum point and the maximum location point, so we can calculate the width, height and length of the object. So let's create some variables. Local width, width, height and length equals max x minus min x, then max the y minus min y, and finally max z minus min z. Okay, so now we've got the width, height and length of the object, and we can pass, so I'm going to take the height, so height divided by 2. So that's the radius of the sphere based on the size of the object. Cool. And what else? I don't know. Let's go back to the wiki. React Physics 3D. So I've got my body, got the shape, add fixture. R3D create fixture. Fixture, R3D, body, create fixture, shape, transform, and mass. So, fixture, the OBG fixture, and here should be the OBG shape. So, we need to call the object, so body is object dot body, create fixture, fixture, and then we pass up. What do we pass? That's for Box2D, but for React Physics 3D, shape, transform, and mass. So shape, we've got our shape just here, so we can call self.obj.shape. Then we need transform, we pass nil, and mass, we need to give it a mass, so 16 for now, and some commands. So that's shape, transform, and mass. So the shape, it is going to be a sphere. Transform, so it's nil because we don't modify the position or the rotation of the fixture. So nil is the default, so everything is zero. The position will be zero. We don't move the fixture inside the body, we just keep it by default. It's all zero, so zero on the x, y, z position and zero for the rotation on the x, y and z axis. And mass, I'm giving it just an example mass. We will change it later. Okay, so I'm done with the player. Now I need to add one more class, function. Not class, function. Function class. Function player1 get. I'm calling it get. And so what is it going to do? It's going to retrieve the OBG and the, so the object and the body of the player. So return self.obg comma self.obg.body, and that's it. I'm ready. Let's run, see. Okay, I don't crash, so I can use now the class in the code. Let's do this. So at the top we've got the stage, some variables, the keyboard, the UI, React Physics 3D. So we have the world here. Then we created some lists to store the enemies and the missiles, the camera. Then we added a background, a moving background, and then here we can add the player. So the player. We need to create a local variable. So I'm going to call this player 1x equals player 1.new, and we need to pass. What do we need to pass? Those parameters. So creating the function here. So I need to pass the world. So the world is here. Going to pass world. Then XOBG path. So the path to the object. So right click, insert into document. So that's the first bit here is the path and the name of the OBG is ship01.obg. So that's all I need to construct the player, and now I can create two more variables, so player1 and player1 body equals player1x column get. So we are calling the get function to have access. So here I go player1 get. So now I can retrieve the OBG and the OBG body. That's what I'm doing here. Player1 and player1 body. That's the object and the object body. Okay. Let's see if we crash. We don't crash. Cool. So we can continue. So I've created the player and the body. Now we need to add the player to the scene. So here it is. So the scene. Stage add child camera. Camera look at child, and here it's not to the stage, but we need to add the player to the camera. So we call camera up get scene add child, and we add the player one. Let's run again. Hop, we don't see the player. Let's hide the background. Okay, when I hide the background, I see my player. So I need to change the order of the drawings. So first of all, we are going to add the background. Then we may add the camera, then the text, or you can maybe add the text after the background, and over all we add the camera, and then we add the player to the camera. Let's test. Cool. Now I've got my player on the screen, and if I move the text, camera, okay, so that doesn't change anything. So when the player will move over the text, we will see the text and not the player. That the player won't be covering the text, but we can change it later. So Hopefully, I'm going to finish here and see in the next video I'm going to move the player. And okay. Okay, so that's it. See you in the next one. Bye bye.